Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point. Today is the last What is in the Night Sky of the year 2023. Today I'm going to be taking you through a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of December. So as always, buckle in and let's see what's really out there. Tonight, we are going to start this tour off several hundreds of light years away from our own planet, and we're going to visit a star cluster that is known to almost everyone who looks up in the night sky in the month of December. Messier 45, the Pleiades star cluster. By far the most famous and most photographed star cluster in the entire night sky, the Pleiades has been known since antiquity. Many people know the group as the Seven Sisters, but in reality, most observers can only count six stars with the naked eye. Since this cluster appears unusually large in our sky, this is one deep sky object that is best observed with binoculars or a telescope with a very low magnification. Even 7x35 binoculars will reveal a smattering of much fainter stars surrounding the bright members. Photographically speaking, with long exposures, nebulosity surrounding these stars becomes very apparent, and you get a beautiful blue-gray hue surrounding this entire cluster. From the Pleiades star cluster, we're going to travel to a very similar star cluster, one that is well known and also very bright, the Hyades star cluster. Like the Pleiades, the Hyades is an easy target for beginners and a favorite with naked eye and binocular observers alike. Most of the stars, except Aldebaran, are roughly the same brightness, but with a smattering of fainter background stars. Look out for Theta Tauri, a pretty double just to the west of Aldebaran. Before we visit any of the other deep sky objects or stars on our list tonight, we're going to bring it back closer to home and see what the planets and the moon are up to this month. Mars is too close to the sun to be visible, but Mercury reaches elongation on the evening sky on the 4th, with a crescent moon to its upper right on the 14th. Mercury is then lost within the sun's glare a few days later. Saturn is only visible in the evening sky, but you'll have a few hours before it sinks too low in the west. A crescent moon joins it on the 17th. Neptune moved into Aquarius on November 29th. It resumes retrograde motion on the 6th and then ends its brief visit on the 8th when it returns back to Pisces. Jupiter reached opposition last month and it is high over the southern horizon by mid-evening. Like Neptune, it's also in retrograde, but doesn't resume prograde motion until the 31st. Jupiter and Uranus share tenure of Aries, but at magnitude 5.6, Uranus is not nearly as bright. It can still be detected with binoculars. Venus dominates the pre-dawn sky with a beautiful crescent moon to its left on the 9th. The moon itself turns new on the 12th, and then full again on the evening of the 26th. So the next stop on our tour tonight is not a deep sky object, nor is it a regular star. It's actually a variable star, and what this is a star that changes in brightness over a specific period of time. This star is referred to as Algol. Algol is probably the best example of a variable star in the night sky. It's easy to observe as it always remains visible to the naked eye, and it has a short variable period of 2.86 days. Its typical magnitude is 2.1, but at minima, it dims to a magnitude 3.4. Much closer to Mesum, its magnitude 3.8 neighbor, just to its north. Now, our next stop is what you would consider a deep sky object. It is a star cluster known as Colander 39. A little to the northeast of Algol is Mirfak, or Alpha Persei, the constellation's brightest star, and you may notice a sprinkling of much fainter stars surrounding it. Like the Pleiades and Hyades, this cluster is a fine view through binoculars, with Mirfak forming a circle with five other blue-white stars, with numerous fainter stars scattered throughout the view. Star clusters are always a treat to view in the winter nights where it's cold, it's crisp, and it's dark. As we always say, these stars look like diamonds on a black velvet background. Now, the next and last stop on our tour tonight is in fact another beautiful star cluster, Messier 34. Messier 34 is easily spotted with binoculars within the same field of view as Algol, just 5 degrees to the east. Telescopically, you'll see a relatively sparse cluster that's a little reminiscent of the Beehive, with a number of bright doubles scattered across the field. In particular, look out for a bright pairing of stars towards the east and a row of three doubles at its center. Alright, so that is our video tonight. Thank you so much for joining us on this tour of the night sky in the month of December, and thank you for joining us through this entire year of 2023. We will definitely be continuing in the year of 2024, so make sure you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel so you do not miss any of our future content or our What's in the Night Skies. Thank you so much, and clear skies.